Morning, children.
Today we are continuing the chapter Water, a Natural Resource.
From this chapter we have completed the introduction with a few question answer and fill in the blanks. This chapter is more debatable and more relevant chapters. A few more chapters. As I told you, the 15, 16, 17 chapters and 20 chapters. 15, 16, 17 and 20 chapters. Hereafter, 15, 16, 17 and 20 chapters are deleted. A small activity will be there from these chapters. Now, we have to complete only two more chapters, 18 and 19. For this 18th chapter, Water, a Natural Resource, we have already begun. And today we will be discussing a few more important concepts of this. Let's now think about it. What are the factors that interfere with the natural renewal of groundwater? I told you, groundwater is a renewable natural resource. Groundwater get deposited after a rain, after raining, certain amount of certain centimeters of rain, you can see that the water goes down and seep down and gets stored in the groundwater, that is called a water table. But nowadays, or even use the water at a rate, faster rate than the rate at which the water, groundwater is renewed. You know, the human beings misuse the water. The greed is beyond the need. You can see that. Okay, so human being, or we use the water at a faster rate than the rate at which the groundwater is renewed. And not only that, cutting down of forest or trees, cutting down of trees for constructing the buildings, factories, roads and dams also, you know, oppositely affect the renewal of the groundwater. So these are the two factors that affect the renewal of groundwater. What are they? The use of water by human is at a rate very faster than the rate at which the groundwater is renewed. We cut down the forest or trees for constructing houses, buildings, factories and roads and even dams. These two factors prevent or affect the renewal of groundwater. Renewal of groundwater. So you know what are the two factors that affect the renewal of groundwater. Okay, now the next important concept is this. That is an example of non-renewable natural resource. In non-renewable natural resources can be exhaustible or inexhaustible. Anyhow, the fossil fuels, you can see that fossil fuels are the non-renewable natural resources. Fossil fuels. What are fossil fuels? Can you give examples? Petroleum, coal, natural gas, all these are fossil fuel because they have been formed millions of years time, you know, millions of years ago, and that have now been transformed into the fossil fuels. So the fossil fuels are like coal, petroleum, natural gas have been formed millions of years time for their formation, and once it is finished up, it will take again millions of years and unpredictable whether they would be formed or not. So such a situation is the main challenge that the fossil fuels are providing us. Okay, so we can understand that these fossil fuels are to be used very sparingly, very minimum rate. Otherwise, within 100 years time or 40 years time, the petrol and the natural gas, petrol and all the fossil fuels would be perished or disappeared. That's why in many countries,
we face, even India also, we face the shortage of these fossil fuels and we have to import it from other countries. Okay, so as I have told, these petroleum sources have to be, you know, identified. In Saudi Arabia yesterday there was a large source of fossil fuel being identified by the authorities, and that so Saudi Arabia is the country which refine and supply maximum crude oil to other countries. So we have to understand this fact. Okay, now the third one, you can see nearly 3/4 of the earth is covered with water. 3/4, nearly 3/4 of the earth is covered with water, but even 1% of this water is fit for drinking and consumption. Most of the water is being deposited in the frozen glaciers and polar ice caps. Frozen glaciers and polar ice caps, which are unavailable for our use, and even water vapor is there in the atmosphere. The water which is available in ponds, lakes, rivers and oceans are only available for our use. Of this, the water from the ocean is unfit for drink because it is salty water. The lakes and rivers are the source of fresh water, and it is also being polluted. You might have heard the problem of Ganga, pollution in Ganga and Brahmaputra and Yamuna rivers. So government of India is taking initiative to filter out this water so that we can use it for some other purpose, and the fresh water can be used for human consumption or consumption of organisms. Okay, now the last one, about 2/3 of our body contains water. 2/3 of our body contains water. You know the importance of this water. Water is a medium for all the chemical reaction to take place in our body. All plants and animals need water. Life in the universe depends upon the availability of water. Where there is water, there we can see lot of organisms. Desert, very less number of organism, whereas tropical region and the river belt and the water body near around, you can see large number of organisms, plants and animals. So for digestion of food we need water, for absorption of the nutrients we need water, and distribution of nutrients to various parts of our body, and for getting rid of waste, everything we need water. So water is an essential commodity without which human being cannot even survive beyond a few days. Without food we can survive for weeks, but without water beyond a few days we cannot survive. So the water is very, very important, essential natural resources which we have to minimize the use, and the wastage of water should be minimized, and also we have to educate the other people in this regard. Thank you.